Hello everyone, and welcome to the Reddit Dota 2 League Central European Time Wednesday Division. My name is Jamsquare, I will be your caster for the day for our match of Good Luck to Us versus the Shocking Eyeballs, who have failed to get their team registered correctly. I think that Tabby is a real stand-in, and that might be why the team isn't showing up. I'm not certain. And as Good Luck to Us ban out the Lich, we will take a look at the RD2L standings and see that both Good Luck to Us and Shocking Eyeballs are towards the bottom of the table with a record of 2-4. Just looking through the past matches here. So Shocking Eyeballs, who are the team on Radiant, traded 1-1 with Insanity Wolves in week 1. In week 2 they traded 1-1 with An Argument for Ethnic Cleansing. And in week 3 they had a forfeit loss to Rock Shandy. So only actually 1-1 in live play. Shocking Eyeballs, it's not a terrible record, as they ban out the Earth Spirit with their first ban. 5 seconds remaining. Good Luck to Us in week 1 traded 1-1 with Anti-Weeaboo Squad. Radiant team ban. In week 2 they lost 2-0 to Happy Little Trees. And in week 3 they traded 1-1 with Tactical Attack Corgi. So their record really is 2-4, unlike the Radiant team's record, which is a little fucked. So, Axe bans coming out from Shocking Eyeballs. Good Luck to Us ban at the Tidehunter, and then pick Invoker first. Very good. Hero in the meta right now. Everyone loves the Invoker, or hates him, depending on which side of the divide you're on. I'm just going to go spam Discord with some links here now that the stream is going. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Okay. So first pick coming up for Shocking Eyeballs. Take a look at some previous matches. They have first Witch picked... Doctor. Well, I was going to say they've Radiant picked Witch Doctor a lot. Usually they've picked him third pick in all of their previous games. Or sorry, in the past three games that are showing up on Dota Buff. A good support pick, great first pick. You're not really showing your hand at all. Witch Doctor combos well with plenty of other heroes, so solid support pick from Shocking Eyeballs. And they'll head into their second pick now. Reserve time. Good Luck to Us certainly played a lot of Invoker. Played it once against Anti-Weeaboo Squad, once against Happy Little Trees. Although it looks like not all those matches are showing up in Dota Buff, so there might be things there that I'm not seeing, and a Slardar will be the second pick choice for Shocking Eyeballs. Not a hero that shows up in their Dota Buff match history for this team. 10 seconds and remaining. Probably an offlane hero still, I would guess. 5 seconds. This is big. Look at that texture on the jaw. I mean, it's like there's not even a different texture for his bottom teeth. It's just one big muddy thing down there. Shameful. A shameful fish man, or fish lady, depending on who you ask. So second pick for Good Luck to Us. I'd expect to see a support now, having gotten a mid first pick. Not too much of a pattern in their support play from what I'm seeing in Dota Buff. Looks like they're changing it up a lot. Play some Jakiro, some Rubik, Earth Spirit, Lion, Witch Doctor, you know, support heroes, so nothing they're locked into. Always good to have that versatility. Lion. And it is the Lion pick. Radiant team ban. And we move into the second phase of bans. Expect to see bans probably targeting the carry position, and we do indeed see Faceless Void go out, although more of an offlane hero, I suppose. And sort of support and offlane bans from Good Luck to Us so far. We'll see if they direct some bans at the mid position or the carry position now.
Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
And it's the Beastmaster ban. Now, Beastmaster, I have been casting a lot of Beastmaster in my limited time doing these RD2L matches. Just so strong in the offlane right now. Pushes hard, farms, jungle camps, gets pickoffs with Roar. Gets that, you know, if you get a fast Necro book, you can just make an absolute nuisance of yourself in the mid game. And then obviously, in the late, even in the late game, Boots of Travel into Ox and things is fantastic. So that's a good ban from Good Luck to Us. If you're not going to be able to pick that hero yourself, probably don't want to play against it. A lot of reserve time being used there by the Shocking Eyeballs, and they finally ban the Bounty Hunter. So maybe thinking about going at some Invis heroes, or maybe just wanting to secure their own jungle and pick a jungle hero.
10 seconds remaining.
Later in the draft, one ban left for Good Luck to Us, and they ban out the Broodmother. Not a hero that I'm seeing much in matches these days. Also not a hero that Shocking Eyeballs have played, according to Dota buff. So I'm not sure what in particular they're worried about, but maybe just hoping to
10 seconds remaining.
Keep their safe lane safe, banning out offlaners with the Tide, Lich, Beastmaster, Brood. So hoping to have a nice safe lane and second support picked for Shocking Eyeballs with the Purple Man Dazzle. Also not a hero that I'm seeing much of since the patch came in. Really not a favored support. Lack of disable sort of a problem, and like Poison Touch
10 seconds
come pretty useless after all the nerfs it's gotten, I think.
5 seconds remaining.
But Shallow Grave, still good. Reeve, still good in the late game.
Radiant team pick.
And the Ancient Apparition will round out the support picks for Good Luck to Us. And certainly have a lot of gank potential already with this lineup. The Invoker and Ancient Apparition with global damage dealing abilities, and the Lion with that quick burst.
5 seconds remaining.
And good synergy with the Chilling Touch as well. Or sorry, the Ice Vortex and the magic damage coming out of the Invoker and the Lion. So the carry pick comes for both sides. Phantom Lancer
Radiant team ban
for Shocking Eyeballs, and Sven for Good Luck to Us. So they banned out all these offlane heroes, picked their safe lane hero, and hope to protect him, presumably with that AA Lion tri lane. So pile the farm onto that Sven. That's actually pretty good versus Broodmother, so not sure why they felt that ban was necessary. But maybe they just don't like the hero. Final two bans now, and then last picks will be a mid hero or
seconds remaining.
And at the offlane, and I'd expect to see a ban at the mid lane hero now.
Five seconds remaining.
That chilling touch on Sven could do some work also.
Reserve time.
Liking this lineup from Good Luck to Us. And that cleave, you know, late game you would think that the cleave hits from Sven will be popping PL illusions as fast as they spawn. Be a question of who's able to get a farm advantage in one way or another, I think. Final ban now from Good Luck to Us. Running right to the end of their reserve time here.
10 seconds remaining.
And it is a Zeus ban.
Dire team pick.
And now they'll look to pick up their offlaner. Finish off this draft.
Darkseer.
And it's the Darkseer. Great offlane hero. Hero that I like a lot. I think this would be my first match cast with a Darkseer in it, although I've talked about Darkseer in a lot of games that he's not been in. But that should do pretty well against the Phantomancer, I think. Although Dazzling Witch Doctor, up to us, have we've all seen the Vac get rid of those Iron Shell creeps, so it shouldn't be too much of an issue.
5 seconds remaining.
But a good offlane pick, you know, can get farm, get levels, more farm than levels really, and sort of harass the Phantomancer without putting himself at risk. And then that just adds to the sort of the team fight combo. The Good Luck to Us have we've all seen the Vacuum Stormhammer plays. You can throw Lion stuns in there, ice blasts, all that good stuff. And wow, so it's not going to be Phantom Lancer in the safe lane. It's going to be Anti-Mage in the safe lane and potentially Phantom Lancer mid. I'm very interested to see what the lanes are going to be from Shocking Eyeballs. I was not expecting an Anti-Mage last pick at all. Just waiting for all the players to select their heroes, and we're in. So, we'll start off with the Radiant side. Team Shocking Eyeballs, we'll start off with a three-man disconnect. Man, don't even have items bought yet, so I can't really tell what the lanes are going to be. I thought I'd turn this off. Phone. Okay, that's better. So, talk about the Dire side first, because it's easier to guess their lanes. Team Good Luck to Us. We'll have on the support Lion, Nils Olav, I'm going to call him instead of... Oh, Colonel Nils Olav, okay. I get it. On the Invoker heading to the mid lane will be Octavian. On the Ancient Apparition, the stand-in, Pruvalicious. Safe lane carry Sven will be played by Chimer. And in the off lane will be Nuff on the Darkseer. Sorry, I'm just trying to check who captains are, I always forget. Okay. On the Radiant side, we will have... And again, with these early Sunstrikes, like, you give away that you're playing Exhort. I don't know why you do it. So Wu will be heading to the safe lane on this Anti-Mage with 8 Tangos to deal with all that Darkseer damage and a poor man's shield. Heading to the mid lane, the Captain, Midget, on the Phantom Lancer. on Sport Witch Doctor Dieter. Dieter. Dare will be on the Dazzle, also playing a support role. And in the offlane, on the Slardar, is Tabby. So we see a five-man smoke bottom lane before the horn sounds. For team, good luck to us. Lion is going to lead the way. There's an Ion Shell up on the Sven. And who is it they're going to come across first? It's Anti-Mage. Blink not yet skilled. Smoke will pop. And nothing's happening. Nothing's happening. Both teams just run away from each other. Might be able to get down a ward here. But just going to trade off runes one for one. And it's just... They even have whereas two sentries and two observers here, but they're not putting any down just yet. Yes, they are going to block off this safe lane pull camp. And get a nice ward down here to watch this bottom rune. And it's going to be a aggro tri-lane. They're going to send the Darkseer to the safe lane and have Sven take on this Anti-Mage along with the Ancient Apparition and the Lion. This is a bold play, and we're going to see a lane switch immediately come out from the Radiant side. Anti-Mage TP's up to top lane and Slardar comes down to bottom lane. So very interesting tri-lane dodge here. Anti-Mage can do okay against Darkseer if you know what you're doing. We need to get those early points in Mana Break, which he has done, so not skilling Blink of that early engagement in the Radiant jungle is going to be big, I think, for this Anti-Mage, because that level 1 Mana Break really helps you in lane against Darkseer. And mid lane, there's going to be a go on Invoker, and he's going to go down. First blood to the Phantom Lancer. Had a bit of help with the paralyzing cask from the Witch Doctor, and able to get an early kill on the Invoker is the captain for Shocking Eyeballs on Midget. So good work on the mid lane. Bring up the last hits here. And this aggro tri lane now uncontested as the Lion rotates through. Slardar farming the jungle. So this off lane being completely given over to the Sven, thanks to the supports here. Lion is going to find Tabby and make this purple man's life very sad. Move speed? Ah, Slardar has a slight move speed advantage. And the crush will come in, and Niels Olaf has extended too far and is going to go down, I think. Oh, eats the fairy fire, but then dies. Provolicious comes through, but I don't think wants to get involved in this, as Dare is coming through as well, so we might see tri-lane on tri-lane now as the supports for Radiant rotate down. But 2-0 lead for Shocking Eyeballs in the kills right now. And pretty even on the farm. Invoker winning a bit mid lane, but both one position heroes farming pretty evenly. You can see Nuff really struggling, doesn't have Sol Ring up just yet, needs about 200 more gold, and has no mana for Ion Shells now. So good play from Whoop. Getting a bit low, but still has all those tangos to work through. Only two heroes hanging around bottom lane. Oh no, sorry, three heroes. So are trying to contest this Sven a little bit more, but AA Sven, really strong lane. Sven farming away pretty happily. TP mid lane, as Invoker's getting low, and two supports here now. And they're going to take out this ward. Try and make things harder for Midget, but doing a good job, I think. Has the bottle on the Phantom Lancer to see what the item choices are. Looks like it'll be Treads first, but no sign of Ring of Aquila yet. And this Invoker, I would suspect, going for a quick Midas, has the Glove of Haste already. Chimera needs to be a little bit careful now, because there are more heroes down here. They are going to get the D ward off on their pull camp at last. And stun comes through, supports come through, and Tabby's going to go down here to the three heroes of good luck to us. They get their first kill on the board. Sunstrike will just catch Dieter, but there is no follow-up hit. and Voodoo Restoration is skilled to keep the Witch Doctor alive. But this trial ain't finally paying dividends, although supports have been rotating out to other places for a while. In fact, both supports on both teams being pretty active here, unlike some of the other games that I've cast. Excuse me. Dire's top tower is under attack. And this anti-mage really doing well now in the lane against the docks here, so it was a good decision right at the start to not leave the anti-mage down in the safe lane up against the tri lane, but get him against that docks here, get the matchup that you want. And the harass coming out onto this invoker is no joke. And Phantom Lancer has taken a big lead in the last hits now, so Radiant coming out a little bit ahead in this laning phase, just able to get a bit more out of these matchups. Lion is going to come in mid, lots of damage onto Octavian, but the turn is now going to come. Midget has no mana left, but probably just going to be able to walk this away and then pop the regen rune back. Probably wouldn't have gone even that deep without the regen rune. Doppelgangs forward, sends out the illusions, and Octavian is going to go down here. Paralyzing Cast comes through to secure it, and Midget gets another kill mid. 2-0 now. Really starting to pull away from this invoker, who has got a long road to climb to get back up to that Midas. And we're wasting some mana there. And a pause comes out from Ancient Apparition. Playing about some lag. We'll get a reconnect. Check out some items here. I do have the Soul Ring up, as well as the treads on the Darks here, so this lane will get a little bit better for Darkseer now. Gonna be Ion Shells all the time. But Anti-Mage with the Ring of Health, doing pretty well. Not gonna be too worried about that harass. And starting to work towards that Battle Fury. Not much to see on the graphs this early on, but as we expected, a little bit of a lead for the Radiant, getting a bit more out of this laning phase. As far as support levels go, it's Dazzle who's really lagging behind, but pretty close to level 3. So pretty even on tar as far as the XP goes. Sort of taking a look at early item builds here as we get going. And it looks like we will be the Ring of Aquila, or possibly Vlad's actually. Good farming item on PL. And Anti-Mage doesn't really want to build Vlad's, so that makes sense. Under attack. As Invoker comes back from impromptu trip to the fountain and immediately takes some more harass damage from these illusions. And this tower already taking a lot of chip. And we're just going to blink forward onto Nuff here, and you know, you got to get off that surge early, because if you don't, you have no mana and then you're in real trouble, and that's what's happened now. Wu's just going to be able to chase Nuff all the way out of this lane. Nothing the Darkseer can do about it. It's going to be harder and harder for Nuff to get EXP, but still can get last hits. And smoke up, is this? Yes, it is a smoke. Trying to kill this Fishman, Slardar again, but Witch Doctor is in the area. Trying to push this lane up onto the tower for a dive, I think. Three heroes from Good Luck to Us would like a second kill, and Witch Doctor almost walks right up into them. I think they know what's going on, and Voodoo Restoration on to get Tabby back up into a healthy state of being. Whenever this invoker gets left alone mid, really struggling against the Phantom Lancer. That Spirit Lance doing a lot of damage, and in fact Octavian could be in trouble now. TPs are going to come in and the Invoker will get away, but there's no chance of a return kill, although Lion is rotating through now. No. Doppel walk down into the river and Midget will escape no problem. And has completed that Aquila, and that's left Sven a little isolated against three heroes, although Lion is doubling back now. And treads are completed. See if it's a first item blink or going for some early lifesteal. Stun out onto Tabby and a mana drain and a second stun, but Ancient Apparition, not quite here in time. There's three heroes from both sides, and I think they're going to cancel each other out. Slardar is going to go back in, look for a crush, but not find it. So hotly contested tri lane here, and Darkseer did go down top in the end to that Invoker. We saw that Wu was really getting the best of that matchup with that earlier exchange that got Darkseer pretty low, so missed that kill, but I imagine it was pretty similar to what we saw earlier. Punch him, no mana for Surge, and then just run him down. Punch him some more. Still lots of skirmishing going on, and Chimera missing out on last hits because of this, and you see really falling behind now. Three heroes from Shocking Eyeballs at the top of the last hit charge briefly there, although Sven gets another few, so good stuff here as far as the farm goes for the Radiant side. Anti-mage about to finish off that Perseverance.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And Octavian picking up this stick, but not even close.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
To a hand of Midas. As Trident Shenanigans. Oh, it looks like we've seen a TP bottom from the Anti-mage. And Witch Doctor getting a kill on the Lion, so I missed that, but Provolicious gets mana voided and gets punched, and that's another two kills, 6-1. And it looks like Shocking Eyeballs are taking pretty firm control of this game. Get over to Networth here. Take a quick look at the graphs as we approach the 10-minute mark. 2,000 XP lead, 4,000 Networth lead, and Shocking Eyeball is going to be feeling pretty confident heading into this mid-game. They've got the lanes working out the way they want them to. They're getting farm on all three of their core heroes. And I think getting close to ultimates. Yeah, level 5. Oh, only 3 on Dazzle, so won't be any Weave anytime soon. We don't really need Weave in the era at this stage of the game. But it will be nice to get the Death Ward up from the Witch Doctor. And indeed buying that Tome of Knowledge to get close to that level 6. And Sven going for that Helm of Iron Will, so it could be Armlet build up or Helm of Dominator. Seeing a lot of Armlet lately as 4 heroes mid. Wow, they really wanted to kill this Phantom Lancer, but guessing that gank has already failed. Not sure if a smoke was used. And the support heroes from Good Luck to Us will disperse back across the map. This mid lane tower starting to look pretty unhealthy now. Serious push from Midget could cause problems, and in fact there's a double damage rune just waiting to be used. Looks like it might be Vlad's next. Possibly a drum, sorry, for the PL. So going pretty early game. Not rushing that Diffusal Blade too quickly. And with the mana break on the anti-mage. Needed a little less. Finally up to 1,000 gold, and deny on the tower, and just barely getting the ghost walk off in time to escape, but Provolicious may not be so lucky. I suspect this ancient apparition will go down. Octavian might not want to stick around here. Just trying to keep the slow up on Midget. Will eventually escape as two more heroes rotate in, and this Phantom Lancer, this Phantom Lancer causing a lot of problems for Good Luck to Us. Rotation in from Octavian to this bottom lane here, pretty good. So a lot is going to be on the shoulders of this Sven, I think, with the Invoker not having a great start. Sven leading the net worth for Good Luck to Us, getting casketed up here, but doesn't need to be too worried about the damage of these supports. Although that Death Ward is available now, but needs to be comboed with some other control, really. And see, Slytherin Crush and Amp damage obviously will be huge. You get Amp damage and Death Ward starts hitting you, you're going to be in big trouble. Rotation in from Octavian to this bottom lane here. Trying to maybe avoid that Phantom Lancer, but Phantom Lancer is here, and there might be a push onto this offlane tower now. Tabby even coming through past the Ancients, that's a little bit dangerous. Octavian is here, smoked up, waiting for a chance, you know, get a good kill, could get up to that Midas.
Dire's top tower
have. He really wants this Helm of Dominator creep to die, but that might not be a great idea. Oh, stun misses from Niels Olav. And Surge goes, but not in the right direction. Casket out onto Keimer. And just trying to keep space. This Midget pops an Illusion Rune and goes to work on this tower. And this whole time, Anti-Mage Wu is just farming the offlane, so... four hero push from the Radiant, creating space with one position hero. There's the first Death Ward of the game, and Keimer on the spend goes down 7-1, and it's not looking good at all for Good Luck to Us, as they're not able to keep their core heroes alive, not able to defend their towers, not able to stop this Anti-Mage from farming. It's gonna have that Battle Fury with this tower up here. Misses the last hit, but so 14 minute Battle Fury for the Anti-Mage. That's very quick. Midget on the PL already has Treads, Drums of Killer. Probably moving into Diffusal Blade next, I would guess. And on this Slardar, heading towards that Blink Dagger, picked up that early Blightstone and the Iron Talon, helping the get a bit of jungle farm early on. And only a few hundred gold away from that blink, so feeling pretty good. Shocking Eyeballs taking all the tier 1 towers of their opponent, and looks like they're gonna push up mid now, as finally the Midas comes out for this Invoker. But Midget diving deep here, gonna get turned on, Doppelgangers away, has double damage going. And Witch Doctor will be here with the stun to provide some protection. Nuff now could be in trouble. Gets the Surge up, but can't get away in time. And Midget on a killing spree. Kicking off the Darks here. And getting even more money. Didn't even have the drums yet. As Slardar picks up a blink. Courier use not efficient from the Radiant side. But this mid tower is in big trouble. And I don't think Good Luck to Us can fight this at all. Lion goes down now. And Pruvalicious hanging out here. Doesn't have any level 6, so can't really stop. Can't really use the, what's his ultimate called? Ice Blast. To counter all these pushes. And it looks like it is going to continue to be for creating space for one. But I mean, this Phantom Lancer, you know, more than 2,000 gold ahead of any hero on the other team, so more than happy to be up here fighting. But the blink use from Tabby, not so great first time, but might even survive. Mech does come out from this Darkseer. Death Ward, though, from over on the side from D-Digger, is going to finally get a kill. Lion goes down, so support for support trade so far. Spirit Lance will get a second support kill from Midget. And this Phantom Lancer just causing so much trouble. Radiant's top tower, it's hard to see attack. Much chance for a comeback here. Is this lead already more than 8,000 XP? And that's not the same button. And more than 12,000 gold at 16 minutes. That's a huge lead early on in the game. And are the drums finally going to come out? Yes, drums finally will come out for Midget. Bought them a long time ago. And Anti-Mage will come in now. So Anti-Mage did build the Vlads in the end. Not the PL. But they have a really strong timing here. I mean, these guys can just roll over Good Luck to Us at this point. I think if they go five man. There's no... nothing that Good Luck to Us can really do. Yeah, their combo isn't really online. You've got level 1 wall, which is great. But this Sven, really not much use so far. Very slow attack speed. Still working towards that BKB and this Invoker. Still sort of recovering from that beatdown in lane. You see Invis Witch Doctor standing right underneath wards as a Roche attempt is going on, and it is going to be successful. And I think Good Luck to Us will just turn around and back out. Oh, not quickly enough. Tabby blinks in, Pruvalicious gets punched and dies. Wu getting that kill there. Nuff could be in trouble here. No control though, and we'll get the surge off and be able to escape. Heals all out of mid lane. Amp damage and crush up. But won't be chased. Chase is going on to Nuff though. Wu with this Aegis. No fucks given. Spirit Lance in, and Mana Void will get the kill. 13-2. And I think the pushes will come to the bottom lane tower now. 10,000 net worth on this anti-mage. Heading for that Manta style. And Fusil Blade is ready for Midget. Just needs to decide what to drop to replace for it. Sven will push up this offlane here. Oh, and not going for the BKB, going for the Sanj. It's just an... Going for an early halberd, try and deal with the one of the right-click carries. Not sure. But TPs are coming to try and fight the Sven, and amp damage is up from Tabby. Primer trying to get away now, but sprint and crush followed by the cast. No bounces though, and I think Chimer might still be able to walk this off. Support comes in from Octavian, but the Death Ward comes out. Oh, mech just in time from Darkseer to save. Ice Blast will come through and hit DD, so it won't be enough to get the kill, but at least a little bit of a positive sign from Good Luck to Us. Although, having said that, rotating all those heroes away to save their Sven means that they're going to lose towers in the offlane and the mid lane, and they're going to lose their Ancient Apparition as a mega kill streak comes out on the anti-mage. So 5-0 on the anti-mage, 4-0-6 on the Phantom Lancer, and anti-mage just blinking forward to get the kill on Lion. Very bold. Might pay with his life, runs through a wall and loses the Aegis. No teammates around here, so might be able to get this, just have the control, and finally Good Luck to Us get a kill on one of the enemy carries. Goes on the Darkseer, which is perhaps not ideal, but plenty of AXP, 900 EXP each for all the heroes involved in that, so that's a big help. Drum's going to be coming for the Invoker, so slowly catching up, and we'll be Sanj and Yasha for the Sven, but only one outer tower left for Good Luck to Us. But a bit of a stay of execution. Shocking Eyeball's happy to back out for now. Farm up their own jungle and wait a little bit. Before they go again, wait for the Sanctuary to be back up. Might see double Manta style from the carries. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Of the Radiant side. So Sven catching up a little bit now, getting ahead of that Slardar, which is good, but Phantom Lancer and Anti-Mage still just very, very far ahead here. We'll see some D-Wards coming out and blocking out this side jungle camp, Radiant side. A lot of wards around this Roche area, although the big man won't be up for a while now. And that Ice Blast is going to be the help with these PL pushes. Soundstrike not managing to hit Midget, but trying to keep their last tower up here. And Darkseer trying to keep these lanes pushed out. Pretty tough lineup to go high ground against. We'll see if Shocking Eyeballs want to wait for a couple more items to come out. Maybe get this BKB up on Slardar and the Manta Styles on the two carries before they go any further. But they're in a pretty strong position now, and be hard pressed to see Good Luck to Us take a 5-on-5 team fight unless they're able to get a really good initiation. But only about halfway to Blink Dagger on the Lion. Darkseer a bit closer if that is the build. No, goes for the Guardian Greaves instead, which is sensible. There's a lot of damage coming out, and that mech has already saved lives. But gonna be a while before there's blink initiation to be had. That's really what I think Good Luck to Us are gonna have to rely on to try and win this game. Wait for Shocking Eyeballs to push uphill and try and get some sort of vacuum wall other things combo Poker having to TP out of a Phantom Lancer shenanigans there. Oh, it might be Sanjin Yasha, not Manta style. A lot of mid-game, early-game items being built by Midget. Not really picking up anything that you want to carry into the late game except this Diffusal Blade so far. And Witch Doctor just got killed, so it looks like maybe he was going for a D ward, or sorry, was probably coming to pop down this ward up here. And that's a kill for the Invoker, much needed, building towards Aghanim Scepter. This top tower is not going to last very long at all. Anti-Mage Illusions. Phantom Lancer Illusions. And that will be the last outer tower taken, so far, no buildings down for the Radiant side, but all the outer towers down for the Dire. And they look like they're actually really thinking about this push. They've got four heroes here, but no, they back out. Phantom Lancer's thinking about it though. Anti-Mage is heading away, but leaving two heroes up here. See if they have to regret this. Yes, Midget is gonna go down, just gets off the doppelganger, and oh no, I was gonna say we'll survive, but no, Lion gets the kill. So just staying around too long there, a bit of a mispositioned play. Shouldn't have hung around on this top lane. And a ray of hope for the Dire side, and they might lose the Anti-Mage now here as well. No, he's gonna get away. Cold Snap will not be enough. Keep this Anti-Mage. Oh, but spotted out by the wards. And beating a hasty retreat. But we'll finish that Manta style. And got a little damage onto this bottom tower. So a bit of a ray of sunshine. We're 25 minutes in, it's 15-6. Shocking Eyeballs are very much in control of this game. Anti-Mage still sticking around here in an area where he could be in big trouble. There is a blink on the line now. But Manta dodge stun, turns onto Chimer, starts punching. But now he's going to be in a bit of trouble. Oh, huge mana void, and Invoker disappears. Wu heads out now. I think potentially could have turned onto this Fen and gotten that kill, but wow. Really confident play from Wu. Not concerned at all about the Invoker. And continuing to farm up, leading the net worth, doubling up, in fact, the Sven, who's not doing great. This Lion, this Darkseer even, is actually the fastest farming hero on the Dire side for the moment. And we're going to see mid lane Phantom Lancer Illusions and Anti-Mage hanging around as well. A little bit spread out here. They're off trying to farm up some sort of items for himself in the offlane, but push is going to come mid, and it's going to be up to good luck to us to defend. Wu up on the front line. Ice Blast comes in here, but we'll mostly miss. Get the Hex out, get the stun, and more follow-up stuns. Bit of an overlap there. Death Ward coming through though. Vacuum onto Wu, and the Anti-Mage just barely blinks away, but Midget has managed to avoid all of that, and the damage from the Death Ward doing a lot of work. Having to try and run away now though, so a good defense. One for one trade. Slardar for Lion. And Drum Charge used by Midget to try and escape. So a good high ground defense there. I think they really could have used all five heroes in the area. Sunstrike will go, but no. Won't hit. And now Nuff pushing out a little bit. Wu is going to come forward onto the Darkseer. Caused some problems. But it looks like Radiant are just going to keep pushing mid. Blink is on the Darkseer now, so there is... this teamfight combo is going to get more and more potent for good luck to us. As they get more levels and as these Blink Daggers continue to come out, we'll see if Sven goes for one next. Could be with 1800 gold up. But going to have to keep defending mid here. See how aggressive Radiant is willing to be. They do have the Anti-Mage in this offlane here. So I might try and do the same thing that they did last time, except maybe not let two heroes die. And smoke, blink in from Niels Olav, Hex, and follow-up stun is there. Can they get the kill this time? They didn't manage to last time. Anti-Mage gets back, wakes up, Mantas blinks away, but the finger from distance secures the kill. and 800 gold. So big kill from Lion. But mid lane, that has freed up Midget to come onto this mid lane tower. Has got half damage onto it already, but will now back away. So similar situation to what happened last time. This time the smoke from Good Luck to Us well-timed, catching out that anti-mage. These high ground wards here paying real dividends. Oh, looks like Lion blinked in blind there and got killed. Not the greatest play from Niels Olav, but continuing to hold this off here. We approached the 30-minute mark, very far behind, but keeping it steady here. 10,000 XP, 15,000 gold, but they're not getting any farther behind. So that's a bit of a silver lining for Good Luck to Us. Radiant Sight just not leaving though, keeping Good Luck to Us pinned in their base, not letting them get out farm. Roche is up now. We'll see if Shocking Eyeballs go for that one. Will be scouted with the Sunstrike by Radiant. Pings out by the Dire, even pings immediately coming out. And that high ground ward has expired, so no vision now for the Dire. We can see only Radiant wards out on the map. Voker has his Aghanim Scepter. Four man smoke heading up towards Roche. There's four heroes here from Good Luck to Us, but I think they're going to have spotted this coming. Lion blinks forward, but can't get a hex off. And just putting down wards. And they are going to head into Roche. I thought that's where Shocking Eyeballs were. I mean, they could try this, but I don't know it's a good idea. Scan goes down from the Radiant. Both scans used, and it's impossible to tell now whose scan is whose. But both teams posturing around this Roche fight. Meanwhile, Anti-Mage pushing in top, so Dire have to run, really. They can't stick around, and I suspect as Good Luck to Us back to defend. Anti-Mage push, we will see Shocking Eyeballs come in and take this Roshan now. So enough heads back. A bit of damage coming off this tower, but be able to hold this off with some iron shells. And the rest of Good Luck to Us staying around. Khymer not really farming right now, but trying to position for this Roche attempt that they suspect is coming. And this will be dewarded by Shocking Eyeballs. Anti-Mage up to about 2k net worth, 20k net worth now. And about to finish that Abyssal Blade. But one ward still up mid, but huge vision advantage for the Radiant. Well, got an advantage in every area of the game right now. Phantom Lancer has picked up the Boots of Travel. Still on Diffuser Blade level 1, up to 1100 gold. So what is the next? I've got an advantage in every area of the game right now. Phantom Lancer has picked up the Boots of Travel. Still on Diffuser Blade level 1, up to 1100 gold. So what is the next item pick? Could be Eye of Skadi, or I might just go for a Butterfly. Get that agility and damage. But the pressure, you know, being lifted a little bit. Roshan hasn't been taken yet. Oh, and a kill mid. Slardar gets fingered and ice blasted. Good stuff. So yeah, Shocking Eyeball sort of, I felt like, had their foot on the throat of Good Luck to Us, but they've just eased off a little bit here. Oh, but we're going to see an Abyssal Blade, and Niels Olav is going to disappear here. Although the stun from Khymer just in time, potentially to save the Lion, no. Blink forward will get the kill. Mana Void doing huge damage. Oh no, it didn't get the kill, actually. Everyone's very low, but not dead yet. Wu gets Shallow Graved and will blink away. Dazzle pops mech, but will die. So that's a 2-0 trade, but now Wu comes back and gets the bash and finally gets that Dazzle kill. Meanwhile, bottom lane, Home is in trouble. Midget is pushing hard while everyone else is occupied with this mid fight. Nuff surges and runs away. Anti-Mage giving chase. Tower still up. Ice Blast saving the day here, but Nuff being defused and will die to the many, many punches of Phantom Lancer eventually. No? Yes. And now Wu and Midget will take this tower as the three remaining heroes from Good Luck to Us are forced back to Fountain to regen. Glyph is popped, but I think this is going to be the lane of Rax for Shocking Eyeballs. Buyback on the Darkseer. Can they make a hold here? Melee barracks almost down. Darkseer blinks mid, going for the courier and gets it. Nothing on board, but very frustrating. Still haven't got Rax. Midget's still working on them. Very spread out fight. Wu jumps in, kills the Ancient Apparition. Death Ward coming through, but targeting a lot of different heroes. Will eventually get the Invoker. No, Ghostwalk used. Melee Rax is down. Tabby, blink, crush, punches onto Chimer. Mid-tire, meanwhile, going down. But Tabby will pay with his life for this dive. Wu comes forward, Mana Void onto the Invoker, dominating spree, 11 kills, mid lane, no barracks, bottom lane, no barracks, Invoker buys back, but I think this is going to be the game. Might even see Mega Creeps here, all four heroes come through, there's the wall, but not quite enough, can't even kill the Dazzle, Graves glimmers and walks away here. So good luck to us. We'll stabilize and drive off the enemies as Niels Olav blinks up onto this cliff. But they're very, very far behind now. They sort of were able to hold off Shocking Eyeballs for a little while, but that XP advantage out past 1500 gold. The gold advantage out past 20,000. Butterfly complete on the Anti-Mage. All this money coming in. 4.5k gold. All the Phantom Lancer doesn't know what to buy. And no real answers coming out. Sven hardly farmed at all since we last saw him. Has picked up a Hyperstone, but that's it. Invoker after the Ags. Similarly, not been able to buy anything. Are going to see it go onto Lion here, and Abyssal Blade used. No chance of survival. And I think this could be the last fight of the game. Chimer desperately trying to get some damage off, but won't be able to do it. Support's just going down one by one. There goes Chimer. And surely this is GG. Yep. Colonel Niels Olav calls it. And Shocking Eyeballs with a score of 25 to 11. Winning game one of this best of two against Good Luck to Us. Behind a sort of surprise draft. Sort of last pick Anti-Mage out of nowhere. Did the lane swap early to get the match with the Darkseer. Phantom Lancer. Excellent mid by Midget. Kept that Invoker from being able to get any sort of start in the game. Really great play. 6-1-13 from the captain, with the captain's innings, and 14-2-0 on the Anti-Mage. Great carry play. Okay, that is game one. This is a best of two. I'm going to take a break from commentary. The stream will continue, and we'll be back with game two as soon as it starts. Hello and welcome back to Reddit Dota 2 League Season 9, Central European Time, Wednesday Division. Matchup between both teams who failed to get their team actually selected for this game. Shocking Eyeballs, who will be on the Radiant side as they were in Game 1. And man, it's so annoying. I have to actually think to remember what their names are. Good luck to us, is the team on Dire. Game 1 was taken by Team Shocking Eyeballs with a very good draft. Last pick, Anti-Mage Surprise. Sent him to the offlane against the Darkseer. Good luck to us. Tried to run an Invoker mid and an aggro tri-lane with Sven. Did not work out for either hero, really. The aggro tri-lane was a good initial play, and it worked well for the laning phase, but after that, the Sven ended up behind the carries on the opposing team and could not catch up. And Invoker just had a bad time mid. So I'd expect to see Good Luck To Us change up their strategy, change up their draft here after getting pretty soundly beaten in the end. They sort of clawed things back a little bit in the mid and late game, but for most of game one, Good Luck To Us really were pretty far behind. So, first phase of bans is completed. Tidehunter ban came out in the first phase from Good Luck To Us in game one as well. Banning out the Witch Doctor, which was a support that Good Luck To Us, that Shocking Eyeballs played in the first game. We saw DDTer have a pretty good game. 5 kills, 1 death, 6 assists on that Witch Doctor, so banning that out. And Shocking Eyeballs banning out the Earth Spirit of the Bounty Hunter, or two heroes that they banned in game one, and picking the Lion. Good support. So similar to the first draft, they first picked Witch Doctor in game one. The first pick Lion here, sort of similar deal. Versatile support with a disable, remaining. With some damage.
5 seconds remaining.
Now we saw first pick Invoker.
Reserve time.
On Good Luck To Us in game one, I suspect we will not, given that they had a real rough time on the Invoker in that game. Was it? Yeah, that Invoker ended the game. 2 kills, 5 deaths. 6 assists on Octavian. And no, 330 gold per minute, really. Not where you want to be on an Invoker. Over 800 GPM on Wu's Anti-Mage in game one. Impressive stuff. So taking a while here, I suspect. Good luck to us trying to come up with some strategy here. Something that they can do differently to come out ahead in game two of this best of two. Doom. And the first pick, Doom. So Doom is a late ban.
Radiant team pick.
In game one. By Shocking Eyeballs. And Lich picked up, so a bit of a safer draft here, not picking that mid hero or carry hero early on, but instead getting a good offlaner and a good support, and something that's going to help them in the early game, certainly in the Lich, which was something they needed in game one. So I'm liking this. I like those first two picks. I like the rethink from Good Luck To Us. I like their approach here. And we'll see what Good Luck To Us do. And they take the Beastmaster. So we talked in game one in the draft about how good Beastmaster is right now. How dominant he can be in the offlane. And I think that's a very strong pickup. And, you know, huge gank potential with the Lion and the Beastmaster, certainly. second phase of bans now. Not much left for good luck to us in terms of reserve time. Targeted a lot of offlane bans in game one, but with the Beastmaster already picked, they won't do that again, and they're going to ban the anti-mage. Definitely sort of reflex pick based on game one. Got clowned on by the anti-mage, so get rid of it this time. We'll see if they go on to ban out the Phantom Lancer. Wouldn't surprise me. At least, you know, make him beat you with something different. And Sven being banned out, so similar thinking from Shocking Eyeballs. It's targeting a ban of something you know they want to play because they played it last game. And they are indeed going to ban the Phantom Lancer. Radiant team ban. So I think it's a good approach. Say, okay, maybe you can beat us, but we're at least going to make you beat us in two different ways. We're not going to fall to the same strategy twice. Last ban of the second phase now for Shocking Eyeballs. And I don't expect them to continue to direct their bans at the core heroes at mid and safe lane heroes. Reserve time. And they're going to ban the Invoker. So not having the Phantom Lancer, maybe they're worried that they don't have the lane matchup to go against the Invoker, but I don't think that's the most necessary ban, I suspect. Would not have been picked no matter what. Faceless Void will be picked by good luck to us. So, I mean, this Doom is not in the offlane. Maybe this Doom is going to start in the jungle and Faceless Void will be in the offlane. But it could also just be a safe lane. Carry Faceless Void. Lich, a good combo there. Get that bouncy frost, chain frost going through. I don't remember spells. Frost Blast. All the ice ones seem to be the ones I have trouble with, like all the different ice heroes and their ice spells all merge into one, you know, Frost Blast and Ice Vortex and all that stuff. So Shocking Eyeballs saving their course for last, picking up the Venomancer. Very safe draft so far, but a good one, lots of slows and control.
10 seconds remaining.
And not locking themselves in into any sort of particular lane setup just yet.
Reserve time.
Good luck to us needing a support and a mid lane hero now. And it's going to be the mid with Death Prophet
pick.
I believe that that's a hero they played in the past. Click over to Dota buff here. Nope, they have not played Death Prophet before in recorded RD2L Season 9 history.
10 seconds.
They play a lot of Invoker though, maybe they expected that to do better. Although they've only...
5 seconds remaining.
Oh no, sorry, one of those was just... Never mind, shut up. One more pick for Shocking Eyeballs, and then we'll head into the final ban phase. And they are going to be looking for either their safe laner or something to go mid against this Death Prophet. Spirit Siphon, pretty good for Death Prophet in lane, although did get nerfed a little in that recent patch. I don't think I've actually seen Death Prophet much since the most recent tweak. But I do like the Spirit Siphon change. Instead of having the Witchcraft, I think it makes the hero more interesting to play. And I think that whole like thing with like, oh, you need to level Witchcraft in this ratio to how you're leveling your ultimate and other stuff, it wasn't fun. Like, it's just a thing you have to learn and do, and then it doesn't actually make the hero more interesting, I don't think. And with all the your Aether Lenses and your Octarine Cores that are in the game now, and the even just, you know, intelligence-based spell damage scaling, I think an ability like Witchcraft was kind of becoming more and more out of place.
10 seconds remaining.
Using all of their time, Shocking Eyeballs, yeah, just like in first games, and I should have actually said, I was thinking in my head, Murano will be the mid pick, but I didn't say it. I know you probably won't believe me, but I was thinking it. So Murano will go mid against the Death Prophet. See if it's the early Ags build. Seems to be pretty popular these days. just drop stars everywhere, and they patched it so that when you're in viz, you don't give yourself away with stars, which used to happen. So last two bans here, probably see a ban of a safe lane hero from... From Good Luck to Us, maybe with a Slark or something like that that they'll be going for. Ah, they'll go for the clicks.
Radiant team ban.
And probably be targeted at a support with this last ban from Shocking Eyeballs. And then we'll finally have the last two picks.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
And it will be the Oracle last ban by Shocking Eyeballs, and they will now look to pick up their safe lane farming carry hero, unless this is carry Venomancer. Spirit of Havos lives on somewhere, but I don't think it will be. I think this will be a hero for Wu, probably.
5 seconds remaining.
Using all of their draft time. And it will be a Broodmother. Very interesting. So really, the swerve drafts coming out from Shocking Eyeballs in both games, sort of trying to make you think one thing and then doing another. So not sure what the lane setup will be. And I suppose that's the point, much like with that Anti-Mage, Phantom Lancer draft, trying to make you guess. So could be Broodmother. Broodmother could go in any lane. Jungle is easily accessible from all lanes now, so it's not too restrictive on where Broodmother can go.
5 seconds remaining.
Legion Commander.
But a little bit of late game damage issues, perhaps. And Legion Commander last picked. So support Doom then, possibly Void in the offlane and Legion in the safe lane. Could be a jungle start. Interesting stuff. An interesting draft for game two. And I'll go spam Discord while we wait for heroes to be picked. Okay, here we go. Game two of Shocking Eyeballs versus Good Luck to Us. We'll start with the pause in DC, because they don't want me to be able to talk about lanes when I go through all the heroes, which is just mean. So I'm going to stall and wait and stretch until Venomancer reconnects. Come on, there he is. I want to see where they're headed. Anyway, let's just do this. On the dire side for Team Good Luck to Us, hoping to get the split. We have Pruvalicious on the Death Prophet, Niels Olav on the Lich, Octavian on the Legion Commander with a big scary helmet, Keimer on a Faceless Void, and Nuff on the Doombringer, also with a scary helmet. For the Radiant side, Team Shocking Eyeballs, Tabby will head to the offlane on the Beastmaster. Midget looks like will be going mid with two pool tangos on the Mirana, the captain. Dieter on the line, hands off a ward to the offlaner and then heads to the safe lane. Wu on the Broodmother, Soul Ring recipe in hand, heads to the safe lane. So will be a safe lane farming Brood, and Venomancer currently slithering up the mid lane, played by Dare. We saw a very aggressive smoke that didn't come to anything in game one from Good Luck to Us. They will put down a ward aggressively here. And I wonder if we'll see an aggro tri-lane again. We've got five heroes at the top, the bottom rune even. for good luck to us, and they might try and make a go on this line here. He pokes his head in the wrong place. Faceless Void waiting up on the hill. Skills time walk. Stun goes out. Lion is going to go in and not get the rune. Bounty Hunter will get it, but will Lion manage to escape? I think so. Siphon keeping him slow, but eating a tree isn't quite going to be enough. One more right click. Yes, First Blood goes to Pruvalicious, but takes all of the heroes from the dire side to make this happen. So looks like it will again be an aggro tri-lane with a support. No, okay, I was like, support Legion Commander? No, it's gonna be dual lanes. Octavian and Niels Olav. Well, I say dual lanes. Lich denies a creep and runs away. So